Good evening, human creatures. Everything's set up, working great. How are you doing tonight, Nat? How are you and Hunter? For those who want to know, that is Mega Man Corruption soundtrack, Reploid Bass, which is probably one of my favorite soundtracks that's being made for that game. Nice, chill. Still keeps that Mega Man X feel of the... So they're kind of the first three games, you know, not strictly metal, but kind of fits in between two and one. But also has a kind of four funk to it, where it's not afraid to dip into techno. I do recommend giving them a listening to. You won't be disappointed. So how are you guys doing tonight? Rawr! How are you doing tonight, Nat? I think I got my ass kicked. Ah, oh, looks like I won. Got my golden gauntlet here. Ah, not too bad tonight. On and off with sleep and work. It's been quite a weird day. Now that I got this, where do I want to go? Since I remember button configs. I'll probably go around getting the rest of the items, so to speak. I shouldn't say rest. I can get the lion's share. Head up to that grave and do some work. No. Alright, let's go see if we can get that cape. Ah, what's the breaking news? I'm kind of curious. Actually, now that I have enough money, let's see what these guys actually have to say. They partake any knowledge. Salutations, hombre. I stumbled upon some text. I'll read it for 20 rupees. How about it? We live on a pale blue dot, the cosmos within us. We are made of star stuff. We are a way of the universe to know itself. Fucking hippies, man. Actually, I shouldn't say hippies. Fucking conspiracy theorists. One of my brothers, when he had his crystal shop open, oh my god, I was plagued by idiots. And those are usually the type of people who would fucking trounce on in. I feel okay now. I feel like I've been made whole. I saw the CCTV footage of the 15-year-old girl shooting and killing her mom from the following story, and she showed the dead body to her friend. I think she waited... Not waited, but wanted the stepdad to come and shoot him too, but he survived. Can I ask something, Matt? Why would she do such a thing? What's the motivations? Boyfriend again? I got the ice rod. The ice rod, it's numbing to grasp even with these gloves. Hey, that's a pretty good bit of information. I didn't expect it to be in this crypt. Hell fucking yeah. Makes you wonder what else has been swapped around. Now that I got some bombs. I don't know, but I feel bad for the stepdad, who sounded like a pretty good guy. Oh, I bet it fucking is. Wonder what the purpose of it all was. Just 10 arrows, it's not too bad. Thank you. gonna say, just instead of going through the whole rigmarole, let's just do this. So there's no motives behind the killings, just wanton murder? Was it boyfriend related like it kind of sounds like? Like, what's the kind of deal here? I know I have already 99, but picking up more is just out of habit. The girl had an antisocial personality disorder, so she's basically everybody on Twitch. Let's see what we got here. Shit, you don't want to die, do you? No, I better do it up here. I fucked up. There are still cases of pretty much emissions gonna come out. So what do you think the cause behind all of this is, Nat? I'm kind of curious. If it's antisocial, it could be a number of things. Could be the threat of losing the internet. It could be no phone. Go get a job. No more friends. You can't drive to school. What do you think it is? I'm kind of curious. Well, it is kind of interesting up until speculation, so to speak. Let's see if we get bombos. Yep. Iris probably created this before the Doomsday Bomb. Oh, I like the little kind of lore behind some of these weapons. I also remember that the one case where there was a girl who tried to kill herself along with her boyfriend and his friend. She survived, but those two didn't. It was also by crashing into a wall with a car. Holy shit. That's usually how it goes. Well, now, please tell me she at least got convicted of murder. Like, or did she try to pull an Ethan Couch here and say she had too much money to know better? Oh, this one's got a total makeover, and I don't have that goddamn, I don't have the cane, and I'm gonna be having some fun here. I'm glad I brought those fairies, though. What do we got here? Iram, you are honorably discharged under the rank of Lieutenant Colonel. That went by fast without me touching anything. The Hyrulean race prevailed to take your gifts. Well, that's it. Game over. Go home. minute, Colonel. Come on, you gotta slow it down there. I can't read that fast. Alright. Wait, hold on. The cane of, Brian, engraved with a rune inscribed blood and country. Well, that was not what I expected, because now I wonder where I'm getting Ganon's place. I am in the blood steeped in so far. Oh, I got a pink little beard. Hell yeah. I don't even know if my defense went up, man, but I look metal as fuck. Oh, hey, Jaguar, and how are you doing tonight? Tired too? Yeah, same. I heard that bitch was already crazy according to her ex, that she and the previous boyfriend tried to break up with her multiple times, but didn't let go, so which probably led to the murder-suicide. Thanks for the shout-out, Nat. And the game softlocks. That's why I always have a backup. Gotta do a little bit extra here, but we can do it. So how's your night going, Jaguar? Go over here and get Bombos back. There we are. God damn it, how do you shoot through the cracks? I always miss that little ledge, I really do. No, you come with me. What did I eat today? Had a little bit of split pea soup. I don't really eat lunch, so technically breakfast. I had me some prickly pears. I had two of them. What else did I have? Oh, and I had a vegetable fajita. That was about it with tofu. Not too bad. Just steady leveling on her own, getting up there. It's homemade. I'm trying my recipe on it. And I honestly think I made it a little bit too pasty and dry, so I'm kind of working out a recipe on that one. Other than that, it's not too bad. What level are you at Rome? I'm kind of curious. Alright, let's get this one done here. So I'm just gonna save and exit. Yeah, that's the problem I had with it. I don't know if I sauteed the onions and carrots right. And I think I added a little bit too much rosemary, thyme, and maybe just... I put in one basil leaf, but I kind of think, probably should have added less. Other than that, it came out good. Nice, smoky. I made sure to really put some smoke on that, on the ham. Honestly, I'm in a good mood for creamy potato soup. And you can't go wrong with that. Like, I used to eat that down south all the damn time. In fact, I might start perfecting my recipe for that. I'm not a big fan of potatoes, but I do love it. I made it a little bit further. Pick up some real ham hock. I tried something leaner this time with just cubed ham chunks instead of the rest. That way I could just give it a shot. And it didn't come out too bad. I did a little bit of liquid smoke. I even went and got some hickory wood chips from a friend and just let it soak in that for about a day. And could kind of just brown them up in a skillet real nice and crisp, and threw in the vegetables, tenderized them in there, not tenderized them, made sure they're nice, soft, and supple in there. I was going to caramelize the onions, but I figured nah, I better back off. And they didn't come out too bad. It's just I don't think I went good with the I don't think I went good with the broth is my biggest concern, because it thickens up like glue after like an hour. You're right, dead right on that. I think it just, I just don't know if I did it right on the flavor. Like, it's there, but it's still not there. That, and I think I skipped out on the salt too much, too. That's been kind of nagging in the back of my mind. My brother's been asking me for some ham and beans, too, so I do need to get back onto that. It is getting that time of year to make more soups and stews. After the game, Link will go. No, Nat, you're not right. You better get used to Daddy Bear Link. I'm sorry. Well, I'm not really sorry. You're just gonna have to accept it. What am I doing? I know better. There we go. Didn't want to do that, but okay. 26 isn't too bad. I mean, you're probably running to that priest probably every few battles, if not every battle. I know, at least I was. And they will give you a fight for your money there. Let's see what we got here. Too close, too close. Ah, shit. Fuck you too. Okay, never mind, I got it. Thing about Madoka Magical is that the alien cat Kyubey was killed by one of the magical girls, Hamoru. But of course, a gunshot isn't gonna kill Kyubey, so he comes back to life and eats his own dead body. Wait, what? Huh. Well, you don't see that every day. Everybody's cool with that? There it is. I hate my phone. I hate your phone too. Now you just texting me some off-the-wall shit. But I like it. So does he like cook it up? Does he like swallow it whole? Or does it come off in chunks? Like, give me the details here. Where would the other things be now, since they're not in their original location? Let's go down to that fucking lake. I have a feeling the ice rod, now that I got the proper stuff to explore, might be occupied by something else. If nothing at all, maybe too. I was asking about the body, Nat. Does he like eat his whole body in one gulp? Does it get cooked? Does chewed up? Does he gotta take small bites? Oh god, I hate this goddamn pond. I was expecting like one big gulp knowing anime. Now over here we'll get an extra set of bombs on us. That always comes in handy. So why does he have to eat his own body? And where did he come from if that body's dead? Was he like birthed from another membrane of a dimension, or is he re-cloned? I'm kind of curious here. Come on, we got this. No, 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 not five. God damn it, I always do that. There we are. Does anyone play the inverted mouse look? Why is mine default? Depends on what you're playing, because like there's certain games I do that on. I don't mind it. If it's default, I can live with it, but if it's something I can change around, I do. It really just depends. What's a good example of it? Like, a lot of Japanese games that the mouse usually is inverted. Like, actually not even the mouse. It can be the joystick, too. Like, Dragon Quest VIII. If you push down, you look up. If you push up, you look down. Because, you know, we're going by how the head operates. Not how we think it does. And that actually does come into a lot of play later. Welcome back, Nat. So... it really just depends. A lot of things I don't change. I really don't. I just kind of get used to it. You're not kind of the only one. Unless it's something I really need accuracy on and I feel more comfortable, I'll change it. Like, if I had to do inverted look on... what's a good example of a game? Killzone. There's one I had to change it on. That I will change on. Just for having a little bit more comfortability in the upper hand. But if it's natural, I'm not changing it. Also, it depends on what kind of game you're playing, too. Wait, how the fuck? I'm an idiot. I was trying to find something? Oh no, another murder time, huh? Oh hell, it's worth a check. You never know. But I always am curious about how certain countries and certain controllers do come by. It is kind of fascinating when you really think about it. Not everything's just black and white basic as we'd like to think it is, or more, as I hate using the term since it's been hijacked, Western-centric. You know what, let's just find out. Sorry to wake you. Yep, we still got our golden bee. Yeah, you can't wall walk on that. Too knit and too thin. Oh no. Give me 1 second, Nat.
Peggy 3.
Let me turn it down there. Oh my god, Nat. Not gonna lie, this is awesome. I really do like the colors. So I see. I've heard about it, but I like, what's a good way to put it? I've heard but not seen. I get the thumbs up. Oh my God, he's raping my ass. There was one that my other brother tried to get me to play called Pumpkin. I think it was Pumpkin Season, and it was really good until just the developer said, "Hey, we're no longer gonna do anything with this game." And it kind of broke his heart because he's really enjoying it. That such is the way of things. I don't have the fire rod, so I hope that's a dungeon weapon here. I do feel a little bit of safety with the red. I don't know what is that even matters. But how did you find out about it, Nat? It's not a red panda? Thank God. I'd have to put it down like the dog it is. All right, that is new. Well, you know, maybe not. Care package, our troop needs help, tools, livestock. Twitter, you mean? Pumpkin Jack? No, it was called Pumpkin Days. That's what it was. His daughter convinced him to buy it. He played it, really liked it. And I don't remember. I think the developers basically come out and said, "Hey, we can't do it." They even had a girl who used to live stream it. And she went on to do different things. So I guess to help kickstart her career, she was a pretty good artist from what I was told. Ah, finally, someone uses the ropes and they look nice. Along with the rats, too. I like the color. Nice palette. Ow. It's always good to not see a total remix of the dungeon, but someone caring enough to at least try. We'll never know. I think it'll map. Yeah, I didn't think it would. Ow. Oh, I see the game now. Yeah, something. There's a game that they don't want to finish anymore. Specifically, good ones. Rip. Yeah, no shit to that. It kind of baffled me because why put so much effort into something you're just gonna dump alongside the road? It reminds me of dead MMOs where companies back in the 2000s and 2010s after creating this lavish, rich lore to games, especially MMOs, when they'd go belly up, instead of trying to, certain companies wouldn't let the devs save the servers. And it's kind of fucking heartbreaking too. All that effort and time just right down the fucking toilet for profit. And that could be the case, but man, it's sure a fucking sad case. I'd rather see it just given to an indie developer to have them go nuts with. At least it lives on in a second life. Or what could have been seen as one. Now it's just gone. Hyrule Army, here lies a domestic traitor's prison. Oh, sorry, poison the Hyrule. I read that wrong, don't ask why. Prove your love of country, incinerate these heathens, a blessed gift awaits. I don't know how to feel about that. I guess the doesn't get overrode, so we're cool. I'll go with it, though I like the way the blue mail looks better. Why did I do that? I'm definitely gonna need the fire rod, at least the way it's starting to look here. Or do I have to use what I think I do? Thought I'd just try it out. Let's see if it works. Oh, hot diggity damn. Oh, welcome back, Nat. I like my gift. I got to go right through the door and loop around. I don't know if it matters, Nat, because I know you aren't into too old of a games, but I was seeing where somebody's remastering Gauntlet Legacy. Or Legend, I think it was, for the PlayStation, which really made me happy. I haven't played that game in a very long time. I like how people are now having the technology to tamper with those N64 and PlayStation games. Right next to 8-bit games and 16, those are probably my next favorite. I really do love the graphics. There's one called Lunacid, or Lunacid, depending on how you want to pronounce it. And I really enjoy that game. Though I don't know when it's going to get a full release. Ollie loots me around, yep. Let's see what we got up here. Oh, it's a pretty damn good game. I really like it. It harkens back to the old... It takes you to FromSoft, Nat, before they shove their head completely up Dark Souls' ass. Like, it takes you back to, in my opinion, the better years of FromSoft. Like Eternal Ring, Kingsfield. And it really does have that feeling to it, which I fucking love. I got an argument with one of my co-workers. Sorry, I was setting up my chair and getting a swig of coffee here. About FromSoft and what they've been doing lately. And like I've told him and argued with him, they really haven't moved past kind of Dark Souls 2 and Dark Souls 3 when it comes to combat. They're kind of stuck in that rut. In my opinion, it's mid at best. Oh no. Oh, that's a cute little guy. Wait, hold on. He's a red panda. We gotta murder him, man. I'm sorry. I tried. He has to meet with death. Yes, throw him down the waterfall. That's so sad. Hope it fails. I did, Nat, until I realized what a little monster he was. It's just how it has to be. Anytime you see a red panda, Nat, you need to put him down. It's just the law of the land. Oh, hell yeah. I was wondering if there were any more of you guys. Anyone over here? Too late, he's cute. He's not cute, Nat. He's a vicious little beast who only lives because Agretzko's popular. The second Agretzko becomes unpopular, you're gonna see nobody remembers what a fucking red panda even looks like. That's kinda how it goes. I'm sorry, you just gotta face the facts. What if it was a hyena? I'd like that, as long as it's not a filthy red little panda. Sounds good. No, they weren't, Nat. A lot of people didn't know what the fucking existed. Don't give me that horse shit. You know better. You're lying through your goddamn teeth. Then it would suck, and I wish failure upon you. I'm sorry, Ned. This is how it has to be. Sometimes you gotta tie little red pandas up in the back and hit them with the shovel in the back of the barn. Just has to be that way. When did you guys get here? Oh my god. His armor. Didn't want to do that. See what we got in here. I can't wait to see it. Oh, this is gonna be a fuck you thing, isn't it? There we go. Fire rod, oh, thank god. Just holding it is troubling. It occupies a sinister air. Let's make a skedaddle for it. Going to Lag City here, holy shit. Pardon me. Let's see what we got up here. Still the same. Awkward silence? You're fine, Nat. I'm gonna scoot up in my chair again because I'm sliding out. Really fix my goddamn posture here and probably get a better chair. This thing's like cement. Swear to god, I'm gonna have fucking bed sores before this goddamn stream's over with. Nat, let's talk about what my brother used to talk about. Oh, I love that. He would always say, have you seen any good films? Or have you ever seen any good movies or television shows lately? I used to love that because if you didn't say films, he'd ride your ass over it about how the difference between a movie and a film is. If I remember right, a movie is dumb entertainment. A film is something to behold. I found a Doom chair, but it cost $600. Nat, the only thing that thing's dooming is my wallet. Oh, what, Toy Story 3? There's three Toy Stories? Yeah, there is. Never mind. I just remembered. Wait, Nat, isn't that the one that everybody claims is a metaphor for the Holocaust? There's four. When did they make the fourth one? Because I vaguely know about three. I don't know, Nat, because I don't watch Toy Story. I don't really fucking care. I've seen the first one. I have not seen the second. And apparently the third or fourth. But, wait, hold on. Fourth came out? Maybe I got it backwards, because I think there's one that everybody says is a metaphor for the Holocaust, and I don't think Disney would ever dare to even try to tackle anything as complex as that situation. Unless there's some money to be had, then they're all over that shit. But Dude, I said you have to care. No, not really. I'm just not a big Disney fan, is all. Like, I never understood fucking adult, what do you call it, Disney adults. That's fucking terrifying to me, but you know, I'm not them. Alright, let's give it a shot here. Let's bait the hand. But bait the hand, not burn me. I'm gonna just... Pixar? Nat, it's all the same. I'm sorry, Pixar, Disney, it's same shit in a different bag. Come on, go off, I want to see this. Alright, we're good. And just in case... Ah, goddamn, knew it. Alright, here we go, Mothula. Got him. That's a pretty quick fight, too. I love Disney films like Bambi, Oliver and Company. I never heard of that one. Fox and the Hound I've heard of, and that isn't Disney, but I like Don Bluth's film too. That's not too bad. I do respect some of Don Bluth's earlier work before he started getting too corporate, but if you want to know one of my probably favorite animators, that's probably Ralph Bakshi. I really do like the trippiness in the art form is, especially Wizards, Felix the Cat. I love like their sing-song kind of feel. Irem, destined hero. No, of course not. Completing a destiny is not heroic, nor is it noble birth, which fortune spread to you. Valiant, I grant. An age. Well, we're getting really deep in here. Commoner, an act of skill. The commoner. What am I to make of you? You survived this nuclear winter, hunter, a measured, courageous. A lion to be feared or trusted. We must hold our breath and wait. A hero to me should be keep us safe. Zelda is most important. Without her, we are headless. I pray we don't foolishly trust you. Keep us safe, Irem. Save Zelda without fail. You understood that, right? Yeah, I understood it. Ralph Macchiato isn't too bad. May your soul echo the tune. Yeah, fuck it. Who cares? Leave me alone. I gotta add more honey to that. Where to next? I could technically tackle Misery Mare or Mire. Might go there. But I just want to get the Ice Palace out of the way. Huh. Where to go, what to do, how to do it. Let's get our asses over. Well, shit. Let's just wrap up the Ice Palace, Hal. Six one way or half a dozen the other is the same. One of my favorite Don Bluths is The Land Before Time. Oh my god, please no, Nat. I had a friend's little brother who used to watch that on a constant basis. Especially the first one. And I want to watch The Secret of Nim. I love that one, by the way. Boy, another classic film is The Great Mouse Detective. I've never heard of it. Secrets of Nim I do like. If I remember right, that was a book. Kind of want to go here just to do the two checks. At the same time, let's just get the ice palace over with. I'm heading there one way or the other. No, I actually do, Nat. Also like the Black Cauldron. There was one, and I can't think of it, but it's about a scientist who comes over for... It's a isekai, if you want to know it, but a different sort. Who comes over, and since he's a scientist, he helps a wizard fight another evil wizard. Fire and ice are another good one, too. That was underwhelming. There we go. Well, that's kind of got me worried when I see a fairy on screen. And it's probably a waste of magic, but let's do it. I do like the little portholes there that looks like it lets the penguins in, so that's pretty fucking cool. Never mind, it was worth it. No, it wasn't worth it. I take it back twice. Hyrule Army, use bombs to annihilate the remaining enemies. You bestow a rich tribute to the skilled warriors who slay this guardian god. Let's try this first. Well, this is your fucking tribute, man. You locked me in. Never mind. Nat, I don't like a lot of Disney shit. In fact, I downright fucking hate it. But I am allowed to like one or two things they did before they became a mega whore. Or I wouldn't say mega whore, we became a mega whore to them. So, yeah, I do like secrets in them. Hyrule Army, use bombs. God damn it. If I get you anywhere, you go now. Where are you? I'm joking. The only one I think I know, the one you're talking about, is something called Fievel, which I hope I pronounced right. That's about it. Like, when it comes to any kind of animated history of movies, Nat, I'm in more in the dark than what you know. Because I generally don't fucking know. Oh my god. He is right on you. Just one doesn't do it. Well, at least I get my bombs, asshole. That's what you call a triple hit, son. Making sure, because I think that's the one I'm talking about. Nat, you'd have more of a clue than me. I know about Fievel, and that's about it. And I don't really know much anything about that. Like I said, my main experience with him was watching him at a friend's house when his little brother was around. That's fucking pretty good body count right there. Rack 'em and stack 'em. Oh. Come on here. All right, let's get stupid. Is this gonna hurt? You fucking whore. That was a good bait and switch. Oh my god, good job. Good job, because I legitimately thought I was gonna get something there. Check Discord, give me 1 second, Matt. Well played. Let me see what you got on Discord here. Yeah, that's the secret to the name I'm thinking about. Yeah, me and you are thinking of the same movie. How did I know, Nat? Oh, it was totally barely worth it. Bombs, not the safest thing to carry around considering the carnage they cause. Still a tool, just like me. Oh, god damn it, he's on me. Now, this isn't too bad. Alright, let's see what you got here. No, Nat, I have no idea what this is.
I can deduce very little. Only that the words are written with a broad, pointed quill pen, which is spattered twice. That the paper is of native Mongolian manufacture, no watermark, and has been gummed, if I'm not very much in error, by a bat who has been drinking Rodent's Delight. A cheap brand is sold only in the serious pubs.
Oh, amazing.
Oh, not really, Doctor. We still don't know where it came from. Perhaps a closer inspection will tell us something. Coal dust. Clearly of the type used in sewer lamps.
What a letdown.
But there's...
Don't speak. Excuse me, Dawson. Steady hand. Yes. Come on.
Go ahead and send it on in, Nat.
yes. Good. No. Bad. Good. Good. Yeah. Oh, come on. Don't go back up. Yes. Come on. Yes.
Ha ha! We've done it, old fellow.
This reaction could only have been triggered by the paper's extreme saturation with distillation of sodium chloride.
Salt water? Great Scott.
It proves beyond a doubt. This list came from the riverfront area.
Oh, no.
Well, I didn't expect this.
No. Elementary, my dear Dawson. We merely look for a seedy pub at the only spot where the sewer can...
That wasn't too bad, Nat. I've never seen it in my life. Basically, yeah, I kind of gathered. That wasn't too bad. I got one heart, I can do this. Come on, Lady Luck, don't fail me now. Got him. Suck it. Oh, that was a good fight. I'll be right here. I do like Sherlock Holmes' interpretations in certain medias, Matt. I really do. I don't really care for the new kind of action-oriented films. It feels like the furthest thing from Sherlock Holmes, who is slow and meticulous, to apparently being fucking Batman. But it is what it is. You must be Irem, the so-named Winter Lion. What do you make of it? An endless winter, birthing gnarled creatures with twisted nerves. Senyu, fear and ignorance bound as one. Is this the Hyrule you fight for? Kingdoms at war, eventually the doomsday. Wish will manifest, all life end, a rusted pulp. It's said patriots, soldiers, go to the cliffside caves, but below Ganon's tower, their cruel service rewarded. The choice has been and still remains yours. Help us, Hunter, free Zelda, or help us condemn the world we suffer to suffocate with ash. No, I really don't, but we're going to just say yes. Have you seen The Iron Giant? Yes, I have. That's one of my brother's favorite films. Oh, I've seen that like 3 times during 2020. Now, I feel kind of obligated to get my ass back in there and find that key. Because I don't know. I'm not really too panicked because I don't need that many dungeon items. Right now, the only one that I'm more concerned with is the Canis Sumeria. That might be in the next dungeon, where it might be up in Turtle Rock. Because I know Turtle Rock gives you the mirror shield, but in this version, it might not. Because I wasn't expecting the blue mail in Skull Forest. Though I think that's more of an appropriate place for it, because that feels more right. Getting it sooner, that way the game's more balanced out, because you go OG Link to the Past, you go from green, you do almost every fucking thing in the game, and then the last technically 2 dungeons you get blue, red, and that's it. It kind of feels like it's just doesn't feel right. That should have been sooner, and I do think Gargoyle's Domain or Skull Woods would have been better for it. My opinion, Skull Woods technically being Dungeon 3. Ah, thank you. I'll let him know when I see him again. Or talk. I haven't talked to him in damn near a year.
You know, Rita, I can't figure out why you'd rather hang around a dump like this when you could be living uptown with a class act like myself.
Isn't it rather dangerous to use one's entire vocabulary in a single sentence?
Frankie, get down, right?
That Cheech Marin?
To say to me, fat boy.
Come on, man, you guys don't scare me. Come on, I'll kill your boys, man. Come on, let me out. I'll kill him. Come on.
Go ahead. Let him go.
Why don't you pick on someone your own size?
Like you, old man?
Hey, Roscoe. Is this us losing our sense of humor?
Nah, I ain't lost my sense of humor. I find that funny. Oh, please.
3 sunrises, 3 sunsets, 3 days, Pagan.
3 sunrises, 3 sunsets, 3 days.
Hey, Zash, how are you doing tonight?
9?
No, Pagan. 3.
3? Oh, you mean just 3 days? Oh, my goodness.
I was quite gone for you. Swear to God, I think you're the one keeping that game alive.
Hey, Rasgo. Look what I found.
Forget it, DeSoto. You gotta go.
I like cats. I like to eat them.
I like how he said it, Nat. I'm not gonna lie.
Get out of my way, Dodger.
That's enough, Rasgo.
Run along, Rasgo. Your master's calling.
Play Hit Drunk for funsies? You're probably the only one I've seen play that game, or I should say committed to playing it.
We ain't finished, Dodger.
Well, I do hear that they're going to be making another Quake, so hopefully it really does rain with a good multiplayer, though I doubt it.
Think twice before hassling us, man.
All right, kid. What'd I tell you guys? Old Dodge can really pick him, huh?
That works too. Matt, I'm not gonna lie. That's cute as hell, and I do like it. Wolfenstein and Doom making. Meanwhile, Quake. Matt, you'd be surprised at how long that used to be just Doom, and where they just focused on Wolfenstein. Like, you'd be surprised. Like, they've shit on Quake. It's always weird to me about flagship games and the companies that make them. You think they get treated more with respect, because while it did make a lot of really good franchises, Quake is the one who... Doom put it on the map, but if you want my honest opinion, Quake is the one that really carried it through. And... I don't really know what the fuck happened. The new meta is super... Oh, pace and tactical. Yes, Quake is too hard for this generation. Yeah, you kind of summed it up. I've seen a lot of people struggle with Quake. Me, probably Quake 2. That was because I never could really get the bunny hop down. But when it came to Quake 3, or multiplayer 3, I should say, not too bad. I didn't mind 4. I really do like that one in Doom's id 3 engine better than I do Doom 3. It fits that kind of game better. Oh yeah, Nat. If you don't know what bunny hopping is, and I'm not talking like Dusk or Blood, go play Quake. You'll see what bunny hopping is. Alright, I was starting to wonder there. Think I know. Nat, you don't know until you played Quake. I do like that the fact they released a new... What do we got here? And that's a new sprite? Well, first move's yours. Second one's mine. I have it back when it came out. Oh yeah, I forgot you mentioning that. Yeah, fuck you too. Fuck you twice. Does that matter? This is going to be a weird dungeon. I'm secretly old. And that, I've heard the rumors about you being in your 40s, so I kind of believe it. It's a lie. Alright, it's gone. That always scares me. But they have been adding a lot of chapters and new things. I've been seeing that. I haven't played Dust 3D, or not 3D, HD yet. I wonder if that's going to be any good or if it changes anything. Quake got a new chapter finally after, I think, forever. Doom got its, technically speaking, another official one. Damn near less than a year after a Sigil 2. Which I do need to play one of these days on stream. God, leave me alone with that message. Holy fuck. There we are. Oh, hey, Robert, how are you doing? talking about Doom and its new add-ons, and, or at really Quake and what happened. Not too bad today. One of my few days off. I was going to use it sleeping in, but I decided to take the risk and stream like a crazy person. Oh, that's going good. Hopefully you're getting ready for October. Thank you for the shout-out, Nat. By the way, both. And they removed a lot, and that is... I'm just going to let that happen. Oh, you got a secret code? What might that be? Oh, the bomb chews. Yo, no, I agree with you there, dude. They can suck a fucking fat one. That's why I almost never hang around the Doom community. It is some of the worst shit you could ever imagine. Like me and you back when we were talking about Destino. That's another good example of that shitstorm. Or even what happened with King Dime and a few others. And that's just the newer heads up, not the old heads that used to be in there. They've all but fucking gone. That's why you don't see me make anywhere near their fucking orbit. In fact, I kind of dread doing anything with Doom because I don't want to attract them. I don't like being on their radar. G-Fairy. Is it Warren G-Fairy? What are we dealing with here? To the Forever Box? I gotta use that one. Another AD? Best part of Quake was Nine Inch Nails. No, I do like the combat in it, Nat. And it was kind of trippy back in Windows 95 days playing a 3D game. But no, I do agree with you there. Like, they have fucking mental problems, man. These wizards are held strong. Hyrule spread ill sludge. Use magic, save the fauna. Why do I get, like... Oh, god damn it, chain chomps. Fun little fact everybody doesn't know about chain chomps. If you're playing Super Mario Bros. 3 and a chain chomp strikes at you 50 times, it'll eventually break its chain. I keep getting ads. I'm sorry about the ads, Nat. I shouldn't have any on. I've turned all that stuff off. No, it was mind-blowing for me back in the day, Robert. I went from Doom, Wolfenstein, who was it? What was the vegetable game? Blake Stone and a few others. And then I went to, what was it? It was for the PlayStation. Twisted Metal. But for the first PC, it was Quake and something else. It's driving me nuts. I can't remember the name. I'll be honest with you. I've been looking for this game for God knows how many years. It's Windows 95 DOS. And all I can remember is it's set in fantasy, but you can dissolve locks with acid. And I've never found that fucking game since. That breaks its chain. Really? I didn't know that. I played only Mario 64 a handful of times. It's not my favorite Mario. I really don't like what they did with the series on that one. Though I was looking at some of the newer... ROM hacks of Mario out there. Yeah, fuck it. I found a ML, why not, hell, Nat? Send it on in. Ain't gonna do any damage. First gen boomers break locks with acid. I don't remember what it is. It's been haunting me fucking... I can't think of the fucking name. I've went on every abandonware site. I've checked every fucking form. I cannot find it. And it's driving me nuts. All I can remember is... one of my friends' dad, he was a big computer person. And he's the one who basically got it up and running. And that's all I remember. Because it was blowing his mind at how that was. Where he could dissolve locks with acid. I have not found that game since. I wake up in the middle of the night sometimes fucking wondering what the fuck the name of that was. I know it wasn't Kingsfield like everybody thinks it was. You remember if it was an FPS game? I think it was. Super Mario, but the camera angles suck ass. Nah, I have a lot of complaints about Super Mario 64, and the camera angles are least among them. I wish it would have stuck with the formula. Like, I don't even like Super Mario, or when I say World, I mean 64. I don't care for World either. Okay, just making sure. Oh. Oh, I like you, ROM author. Well played. Well fucking played. But I do remember it. It was an FPS game, or was it? I remember it being FPS, because I remember having it some of the clankiest fucking strike. It had a battle system close to Elder Scrolls 1. Where how, if those who never played the first Elder Scrolls and only fuck around with Skyrim or maybe Oblivion, in the first Elder Scrolls, your slashing and stabbing went with how you swung your mouse. Kind of like Silver. If it's POD, it's 90s FPS title, that little no. I never could find it. I always forget that Super Mario 64 doesn't have the power, flower power. No, it doesn't. It mainly has the hats, which I didn't find anything wrong with. Come on, just... God damn it, it's bomb time, isn't it? It's not bomb time. It had the flying hat, it had Metal Mario, and I think that's about it. But to me, it was just unimpressive. I didn't like going around collecting everything. I don't really care for Super Mario World. I really do like Super Mario Bros. 3 the best. I love new Super Mario Bros. And its ilk, but when it comes to newer ones, I can't really judge because I haven't played it after that. Like, that was my breaking point, was there. I didn't really follow Mario after that. How do I kill you? I sure could use that golden bee right now. Maybe later. Because it feels cheap to me, Nat. I don't know how you feel about it. I really don't know if anybody in this chat really feels about it. But to me, that feels like padding out a game. It's like bullshit, and it's like shooting the rodeo in a movie. It feels like they're just cheaply padding everything out. Well, that got nothing accomplished. I'm glad I did that. I'm gonna fight you. I think the last time I was trying to download My Little Pony RPG called Super Lesbian Horse RPG, it was Fluttershy and Rainbow Dash parody of Super Animal Lesbians RPG. Nat, where the hell do you find these things? Are you still going around LimeWire? No key, but I like the setup here. It is menacing. I think what I enjoyed about Super Mario 64 is how the C button for the camera was like an unsolved... Yeah, oh my god. That shit will never be fucking figured out. I love how the N64 treated the C buttons. I really do. Turok, they were your moving buttons. Left, right, up, down. Really strafing buttons, if you want to call it. Mario, the camera buttons. Legend of Zelda, kind of item buttons. Like, they were all over the map on how to treat those buttons. Alright, let's see what we can do here. But I do agree with you there, Robert. They're going to dig those fucking games up 1,000 years from now, and no one's going to know what the fuck they even meant. I like the door, though. That big gaping fucking wound right there. Go get some keys. Let's not. Wait, now that he's dead, can I push anything in? Oh my god, thank you for finally saying it. I usually get called crazy when I say that about Turok 1. Like, the remaster they did vastly improved in how that game handled. It should have been GoldenEye, but it was done. Yeah, you got a point. A lot of people overlook how smooth GoldenEye was. In fact, I've been meaning to play that one for quite a while here, because fuck me, man. I think I must have deathmatched 1,000 times in that fucking game back when it came out. If they only just made a better GoldenEye 2 instead of making whatever the fuck Tomorrow Never Dies was. What were they talking about? Nah, I don't fucking know, man, but they were hopped up on some shit. That much I do know. They were getting the good shit in Japan that week. Because if you look at that controller, it looks more like something that like a movie would make to mock a video game controller. Wrong hole. Well, I had excellent FPS controls. Turok should have been open. Yeah. No, I agree with you there. That's what kind of fucking disappointed me. Because I kind of played GoldenEye before I did Turok 1. In fact, I got them on the same week. I should say my friend's dad got him on the same week, and we played him. We just watched GoldenEye back when it came out, and he wanted to watch it before he played the game. And it was kind of fucking trippy. And I don't know how the fuck they messed up, but Rare is known for making really tight games. Unless you're like an early fucking Donkey Kong fan, then that's another story. Yeah. Another one that really got shitted on in the Turok series, and want my honest opinion, is probably Rage Wars. That one didn't have that good, and Turok 3 didn't have good options either. Endo is high on acid. I don't know what the fuck they were thinking of. The only game that murdered the movie it was based on. That's one way to put it. I don't think you're ever going to get a good game like that again. I really don't. Don't shoot me, little eye. That's one of the few games I'll probably admit that's probably a really good kind of adaptation. It's probably Willow for the NES. Technically, if you want to really blink or squint hard. What the fuck was the name of that movie in the 80s? Why am I forgetting your name? Because it was pretty decent. But it was based on a movie. The Batman one was, but I'm not watching it or playing, I've only heard. And then GoldenEye. I think those are the only ones that kind of really nailed that format. Remember the Power Glove? Now you're playing. Also, Freddy referenced it. Yeah, I do, Nat. Now I'm playing with power. I was trying to go buy the goddamn thing. Batman had a game like the movie? If I remember right, it did, but I think it was for the Sega. I'm probably misthinking that. Oh, you also kind of had the Jurassic Park games, which weren't too bad. Fuck you, you fucking eye. I swear to God, I'm going to poke you out when I get a fucking... As soon as they make a ROM hack where I can kill you, your ass is fucking dead. Raise your hand if you feel like you just wasted your time and energy. Not everybody at once. I was thinking of the latest Batman. No, the one I'm thinking of was like 92, maybe 91. It was for the Sega and I think the SNES. I'm probably wrong. But it was based on Jack Nicholson's one. Just don't quote me on that. My memory's really bad with that one. And I don't play Batman or watch it to really know. Oh, you're a lifesaver. Well, that's kind of awkward. Right, we'll go with it. Well, just in case. Now you're playing with power. I do like the reference, Nat. Like, the power glove was always kind of a trippy thing, because I did own one, by the way. Picked it up at a garage sale, if you believe it or not. I don't know why it would be in such a thing. Fucking die. And just power through the pain. Give me 1 second, Nat. There we go. Holy shit, the real final boss. Well, I was trying to find the MLP game, but most of the videos are like 30 minutes. I was a person who sold it. Now you're cursed.
Wait, what?
Matt, I still remember the Mega Man game, and that was a pretty good one, too, if it wasn't just for the goddamn keyboard controls I am not a fan of. And that shield does not block fireballs. I can use that later on. Let's go see what I dug up here. For some reason, I immediately thought of Been Drowned right now. Make sure that game isn't haunted. Oh god, I remember when that came out. I remember having to deal with a bunch of kids I worked with at my school. I worked at Save-A-Lot then. I was a butcher. And one of the guys I worked with is really big in the creepypastas. And now, you know how I know him best? When I was working with him, after Dimebag Darryl got killed, he went into the meat storage where we were and hung up a picture of him. Even I said, man, you kind of got to take that down. As much as I do like Pantera, yeah, that has to kind of come down. This is our job site, not a bedroom. Be nice to them, they're just kids. Nat, he was 20 fucking two. Alright, no hidden ones. That's good, that's good. See if that gargoyle statue can move. Yep, we're in business here. And we got two locked doors, so we're in. Oh, finally, they're actually utilizing the slimes in Zelda. Holy shit, finally. It's never too late for, like, something. I never said it was, Matt. It was just. Like, that'd be like if Robert went to his construction site where he's hanging drywall and then put up a picture of Bad Sonic. He'd probably get the same looks I did when I gave that guy. That's how I'll remember him. I remember his last name. Or actually, I remember both of his names. Josh? No, just leave it Josh. I want to dox him live. My boss does not. Just make it as weird as possible, Robert. Don't even tack the poster on. Just move it from room to room. Just room to room with you. And if any, just try to make it a centerpiece that you have to bring up in a conversation. Like every time you go to talk to somebody, no matter how minuscule it is, go hang out by the poster and point at it. Like clear your throat and accidentally point until somebody wants to talk. And then let them fucking have it, man. I'm gonna pour me some water on that when I'm out of coffee. It'd be the same thing with me and Doom. Or really Mega Man at that this fucking point, because I don't think 9's coming out. Hell, maybe it is. We don't know. I love Pantera, Drag the Waters, Walk, a bunch of others. And you got good taste. Far Beyond Driven is probably one of my favorite albums. Motivating music helped me move out of my mom's house at 18. True. It helped me get used to my work week. I love schools. They teach you how to work a 9-to-5, but they really don't explain to you how bad you're gonna get fucked during it. We need more Panteras, yeah, but we're never gonna get that reunion. Especially after everything. I wanted that bomb. Alright, put on the foot powder here. Now we go. I mean, it taught you enough. That's what you could say. Like, I graduated high school, but even after leaving, I always felt like I didn't learn enough there. That's why I always hit up the local libraries. And the town I lived in, I shit you not, the library got hit by a tornado. Maybe about 4 or 5 months after I graduated. And then they voted on the town to just, like, not have a library. Meanwhile, tornado hits the local church, and that motherfucker gets repaired overnight. Since Donnie Darko dies in the film, does that mean I have to take photos of him down? Nat, wait, the only thing you got to accept is not Donnie Darko, but if Donnie Darko 2 is a real thing. I really like the layout he does here. Your parents after 20, so you have a problem that needs fixing? Oh, I didn't have to worry about that. I got kicked out when I was around 13. I get kicked out, then asked to come back home, get kicked out again, asked to come back home. I was couch surfing a lot until I turned 16. And trust me when I say this, all night laundromats do keep you warm. A lot of jobs in the paper, yeah. Fuck yeah, I remember that. Right next to the Lonely Hearts section. Random, I wish Skin would release more songs fast. I know that they're probably taking time. Nat, what do you think it'll be? I'm kind of curious on your point of view. Do you think it'll be on who? Wish my parents kicked me out. Be careful what you wish for. You just might get it. Let's just say, Nat, you really find out who your friends are. It was really rough. Like, 13, kicked out, like half that year she invited me back in, mainly to help her, because fucking by then the cancer was turning her literally everything into Swiss cheese. We would have an argument, I'd leave again for another 6 months, and same thing up until I turned 60, and my friend's dad took me in and basically gave me the option. You're gonna work, or you're gonna go to education, or you're gonna do both, but if I catch you doing none of these things, you're right back out. He had a landscaping company, so to speak. Not a big one. Not one that made him rich or anything like that. So that was the job I held up until I turned 17. I got paid under the table a lot. And when I turned 18, went and started working. Well, like I was telling you guys, used to go to construction sites. Look to see if they needed any scraps picked up. Bricks moved around. Covers. Gens moved. Anything like that. Ditches, if they need to be dug, if anything needs to be mowed, clipped, weed-eated. Work or don't, swim or drown. Yeah, that's basically what he said. It's up to you if you want to be a fuck-up in life. I'll give you a chance, but I'm by no means going to do it for you. And he was a pretty good dude. He ended up dying of cancer, too. He's second person. My mom, I think it was liver. And I think his was blood or stomach then blood, if I remember right, because it metastasized and went to his brain. What the fuck was the point of that room? Other than... I'm seeing a lot of those in this. Maybe it's just me. Let's see what we got in this room. I went right back into the same room. There we not go. Ah, oh, I'll eventually get it right, folks. I swear, I'm only partially mentally hindered. Not full blown, not just yet. At least the doctors haven't told me. There it is. Alright, here we go. No, Donnie Darko, Nat, it's a real thing and you're gonna have to live with it. I'm sorry. I have been summoned. Ah, god damn it, I just got railroaded. Oh god, Nat. Red Panda in Cincinnati, so you don't mind a record low temperature. Look at the dirty little thing, Nat. You know what you need to do when he's jumping up? You take your knife and you go right to the pelvis and you just cut upwards until he makes a really good fur coat. Look at him. He needs to be put down like the rabid little beast that he is. Red pandas are also called fire foxes and Himalayan raccoons. Yeah, that's too evil to let live. Their bushy tails doubles as a blanket in winter. Alright, Nat, I'm going to let you decide. When can we start hunting these things back to extinction? We need to bring that back. I think what it was, I think what I like most is that I'm old enough that people younger than me won't run from the word long enough to screw up their lives. I do kind of get that kind of sense now that I'm a lot older. I do, like, it's like I was explaining to my brother who turned 30 not too long ago that, you know, I was fucking around as a teenager, but the second I turned my 20s, I was looking back at myself as a teen thinking, God, what was I thinking? Then when I hit 30s, or at least my mid-30s, I was looking back at my 20s thinking, and I thought I had my shit together. What was I thinking? But now, just like you said here, Gen Z and Gen A are collectively morons. And you're not too fucking far, because they technically don't have to grow up. There's no real kind of hard... There's hard shit facing them, but... And I'm not saying they don't have the patience or the people skills to do it. But it feels like they're being dealt a raw fucking deal here. And a lot of it's due to their own moronic fucking activities. Giving, like, look at TikTok, look at slang. Every generation has its slang, but when you fucking refuse to stop using it, after you reach a certain age, you kind of doomed us all. And Kai Cenac isn't gonna fucking baby you. Giving your money to certain people isn't gonna fucking help you. No one's gonna swoop in and save you. It's kind of like what we used to picture the fucking back in the 50s. We thought by the 90s we'd have flying fucking cars. And no, we still had some more of the same infrastructure that was crumbling around us, just with a shittier deal for everybody. I do too. I'm starting to have to work with a lot of mid to late Gen Z. Now that the millennials are starting to disappear, and a lot of them are even troubling, but when I have to come in contact with any Gen Alpha, especially the, I should call it the older ones, by that I mean 15 or 16, and oh my fucking god, man, it's a headache and a half. I was with a patient 2 days ago, and I can't break HIPAA here. We had to work with a 15-year-old shadow who was coming in with us and going into room to room, and I had to explain to him. And the mouthful of shit that he was talking to a fucking... And this... I was talking to a Vietnam veteran here. To the point where he got ordered out of the fucking room because he was unable to speak proper fucking English. Wow, thanks for making me so much better. You know red pandas are endangered. Yeah, I know, Nat. And if I had my way, due to a Gretzko, I'd stomp them out permanently. Oh, he does. He's pretty fucking cool, dude. I let him do what he wants to do. He either pops in a Fish album or he'll listen to some Grateful Dead and party it up like Jerry Garcia. And I leave him the fuck alone. If that man needs anything, he gets it. But if he doesn't need anything, I ain't gonna go in there and bother him. I do try to make it easy on his ass. And he's a pretty righteous old fucking dude. The shadow I had in who came in from high school, oh my fucking god, was just making him irate. And the one word that sent him over was jelly. He kept saying jelly, and he just told the kid, look, dude, just leave me alone. No, Nat, we're not leaving the red pandas alone. I'm not going to stop until they're all turned to coats. And I would too, for that fucking matter, Robert. I agree. I really like this. And there's no kind of invisible blocks holding them in. Holy shit, that is good. And I got the... Would study in it, study his book. I think it's real. I like that. Holy shit, that is some good authorship right there. This ROM hack is back on my good side. But it is interesting how these generations are starting to collide and work, especially when you work where I do, where they just kind of merge into one, where you don't have just three generations of like X, like me and you, millennials, and then maybe baby boomers. You got fucking Gen Z, Gen Alpha coming in to monitor. You got some, I rarely actually see any fucking Gen X anymore. Like they're almost nowhere to be seen. It's either old baby boomers or right to millennials. It's gonna hurt. But I got my dust. Nowadays, I see Gen C, they were born in the wrong. Yeah, you guys kind of got fucked like millennials did, Nat. I'm sorry to say this. Millennials didn't stand a fucking chance to begin with, but you guys by no means are getting it any fucking better. The old saying is, you want the tip or the shaft? What they don't tell you is eventually you're gonna get the fucking shaft, and you guys did. And X playing Doom, I'm listening to Megadeth right now. Yeah. But it is kind of interesting watching these generations kind of work and meld together. Because it's... I like to sit back and observe it. Observe. There we go. If I can get proper fucking English going down here. And when you put all the slang and all the shit aside, the one thing that really stands out the most... is honestly how they interact with people. That truly has me intrigued a lot. And how they do it. Like, Gen Z and Alpha have this wishy-washy way of handling people. Alpha treats everybody like they're fucking online. And millennials treat everybody like they're going online. But with Gen Z, they have this kind of pseudo way of doing it. Like, they're almost suspicious of the people they're working with. And I fucking love it, for a matter of fact. See, grew up with shock sights. No wonder why they're fucked up. It's not just that, Nat. It's just their proclivity to how they handle things. One of the, like I was going back to what me and Robert were talking about, was like the way they talk. Everything has to be put into certain slang. I'm right back to the white sword. No wonder why everything's taking a fucking hour and a half to kill. So, this is going to be a really interesting fight coming up here. I also find it's funny that when people say kids nowadays don't go outside and play. Nat, it's not that they don't go outside and play. Y'all that. Kids. It's... the older generations and how they treat them. There was a kid who went outside, who went fucking fishing in a pond, and it's a viral video. And instead of being like what I would basically do, because back when I did have some property before it kind of got stolen, it had a fishing pond on it, and I loved the fuck out of it, and I let the neighbors fish on it. Shit, I can't use it all the time, and I don't mind if you want to go get some grub. Instead, they go out and fucking harass them for it, and they can't figure out why these kids don't go outside. So it's kind of like the old saying that it takes a fucking village to raise somebody, and we're fucking failing them gloriously at that. I didn't even read the whole thing. No, Nat, I didn't. I'm trying to read about 5 different things. Give me 1 second here. I do not trust these little chews. Can I even paralyze these fuckers? Yeah, I can. I thought it was with the boomerang. That's right, Link. You shoot that wall. Now let me get the safety here. Yeah, no, that's the one I'm talking about. Yeah. It wasn't his property, come to find out. It was somebody else's. He was part of a homeowner association. And if you've ever dealt with a homeowner's association, I'm sorry. I really am. Like, my heart goes out to you. One of the golf clubs I worked at had a bunch of people who worked at a homeowner's association. They're the most void, dead fucking people I've ever met in my life. Alright, let's do this. Actually, let's go down and do this. Now let's go up and do this. We just need to light the torches. But you have that, Nat, but it's also how they kind of view the world. Like, that's also a kind of interesting thing, because your generation, Gen Z, late to mid, is now interacting with Gen A. And you're going to get a kind of a crossover pollination of how they act. Like when you and, I can't think of her name, who is in the chat here, they make use of heavy slang. And that often kind of bleeds out in how they treat people too. When you treat people as not people, you get a kind of interesting thing. And by when I say not people, I don't mean as like you don't see them as less or lower of human beings than what you are. I mean is how you kind of, what's a good word for it? View their status. Oh, I'm gonna get fucked hard. I gotta wait. NZH Gen Alpha. Oh, I know, but Nat, you also gotta take responsibility because you're the direct cause of breeding them, just like Gen X is for millennials. God damn it, I was hoping you go above me. I'm free. Alright, the walk of faith here. So someone's an Indiana Jones fan. Oh no, there are some millennials, Nat. I'm talking about the late ones. Or the later ones who basically spawned what was left of Gen, fucking, goddammit, Gen X, who spawned the last part of the millennials who grew up with Gen Z. You always gotta remember, Nat, there's always kind of a overlap. Alright, here we go. There it is. It's just one. Get up! God damn it, that took a big chunk out of my ass. Please be the big key. How do I manage to hit the one thing that's staying stationary? Like, that's a gift right there. Z is not the six. No, it's not. It's not, and it never fucking will be. What are you in this game? I am Old Man Link, who's trying to stop a nuclear apocalypse from happening, so to speak. And right now, let me get away from that goddamn noise. Zelda is leading a rebellion, trying to save the kingdom. She's basically a tree hugger. And then you have Ganon, who's basically ushering in the apocalypse. And every dungeon has two way of going about things. Like, I can choose the peaceful way of the dungeon, collect items, and not have to slaughter anything, technically speaking. And then I can choose the other way, which is normal Legend of Zelda. And right now, like, I should say in the light world, you kind of had different ways of getting items. Like, all the pendants were in town and peacefully hidden. But in the dark world, what he's trying to do is split the dungeons in two, which is really not a good idea. You should have, like, one dungeon for a good thing, one dungeon for a bad thing, but clearly mark what they are. Because halfway through in this dungeon, I'm either doing the bad route or I'm doing an even worse route. And I can't really tell, but I like what the idea behind this dungeon, or not dungeon, this ROM hack is. But at the same time, I think it's being poorly carried out. Like, I see some beautiful fucking rooms here. A lot of good setup. A lot of good shit. But at the same time, it's carried out a little bit too haphazardly. And I'm not blaming him for it, because this might be his first ROM hack. And I ain't gonna fault the old boy for fucking trying. He's gonna get points for that. But at the same time, holy shit, man. Some of it I'm questioning. I like where it's headed. I don't like where it's going. Oh, you're welcome. Thanks for making sense of that. Cancel culture is... That cancel culture really isn't a thing, though. Like, that's just a fucking boogeyman that's been held over everybody's head for the longest time. I hate that word being used. Before I cross that bridge and might be permanently locked out, let's stay over here. Gen X with the most serial killers, generation Gen Z with the most school shooters. We can always agree, Nat, that we all hate each other and want each other dead. So I might actually have to head over there. Like, a lot of rooms, Robert, is what you see right here is just... Was this a mistake? Was this an art design right here? Or was it on purpose? Like, certain rooms I've walked into throughout this game so far, and they have no purpose other than looking pretty. Which, I mean, that it reminds me of certain Doom ROM hacks. Or not, that came out weird. Certain Doom WADs. You'll either get a slaughter map, you'll get a fucking a normal map, or you'll get a map set that is just the author showing off how good he is with textures and what he's willing to do to it. I mean, it's pretty obvious that there are barely any serial killers nowadays. Nat, don't ever say that. Just because you don't hear about serial killers in Japan and France doesn't mean there's not serial killers going on in Japan and France. I was born in the wrong generation. I was worth. You say that, Nat, but remember, this is a time before sewage. So you're throwing shit out in the street. And I mean, I like to romanticize the 1880s, but that's the Gilded Age, where me and Robert would be working to death and you'd probably be in prostitution, if not a trad wife. And not the fun kind. The unfun kind. And I realize I have normal shield and I'm getting my ass kicked here. Where did my shit go? Did I hit a like? I don't remember. To be fair, the FNAF movie wouldn't exist then either. Robert, you're making kind of a hard bargain because that's kind of selling me on it. And it is a good trade-off. No FNAF versus no sewage. I'll take no FNAF first. The big key, holy shit. Talk about going the long way around to something short. I do like the new door frames, though. Like, this is what I'm talking about. I love what he's doing here, but I don't like how he's carrying it about. I think if this ROM hack went back into the oven for a little bit or a few more months and a little bit more design, a little bit more playtesting, you'd have something good. I really do. A lot of Zelda ROM hacks are either getting into the Kaizo territory or just plain fucking dumb. That's what always kind of worries me when I play these. Oh yeah, they're filming a second one in October, I think. I'm not excited, Nat. I'm actually kind of depressed. Now, just in case. Any keys? Nope. Come on. Get my foot powder out. I don't give a fuck what you think, pencil neck. I got that from the game. Wait, what? When did they have that kind of threats in FNAF? Oh, Nat, Robert, what do you guys think of the new Minecraft movie? Pour it on me, please. Do you like how Jack Black stabbed Kyle Gass in the fucking back for that shithole fucking film? No more D. Just sprinkle it on there. Is everybody hating Jack Black like I have for decades? I don't remember the push area at all. Is that the only ROM hack? Yeah, it is. Like, what it's basically trying to do in this dungeon is you could do the evil route and go and get the cane, or you could do the good route where you don't need to get the cane and you can move the statues. He's trying to have it both ways, and it kind of works out funky. Because at the end, they kind of meld to one point. It's kind of weird. Like, let's say the ice dungeon I just did, which I probably need to go get the chest at, but let's hypothetically use that. You're going into that dungeon, and you can either use the fire rod to kill, and I'm putting up air quotations, monsters that are supposed to be people, or you could try to maneuver it peacefully, kill only some of them, get the keys, and beat the boss with maybe the medallion. That way you don't have to use fire to go do the evil route. But at a certain point, they merge together, unfortunately, because it's such a small dungeon where you kind of overlap. It's basically, you get a choice between A and B, and both are wrong. Not even Minecraft fans like the trailer. Also, the trailer has lost the likes. The subtree is better. I agree with there, Nat. I agree with there. I do like Sonic 3's trailer a lot fucking better. Oh, who the fuck asked for a Minecraft movie? Why did they make Jack Black? Who the fuck is Steve, and why should I care? I'm looking at the trailer, Nat, with what the fuck, Jason Momoa looking like, I don't even know what the fuck he's doing there. I don't know who the other lady is or the two kids are. None of the shit makes sense. Minecraft is shit. Yeah, I did. And I'm so glad when we raided that one lady, that is not the clip that came up. I have gotten banned thanks to you, Robert, from a few streams I've raided because of that clip. Thank you for that, by the way. No hate from me. If you ever want to know how I feel about Minecraft, simply play that clip or just ask. Steve is a main... Nat, I didn't even know Minecraft had a protagonist. Steve is the vault skin in Minecraft. My god, that's kind of depressing. A guy with a blue shirt and brown hair, I think I could do better. How the fuck did Minecraft become so popular, man? Talk about brain rot for your fucking mind. Nat, I'm being serious with you. I'd rather have fucking, Stevie Wonder or Ray Charles give me a lobotomy than play fucking Minecraft for any longer period of time. Let's just face Minecraft for what it is. It's how to steal money from kids online. I don't know, crafting and block game survival. The closest you're going to get me to play Minecraft, Nat, is probably Dragon Quest, what was it? Dragon Quest Heroes? No, not Heroes. I can't think of the name of it, but it's sort of like that. And the only reason why I want to play that is it's a twist on OG Dragon Quest. The block shit doesn't even matter to me. You know what? I gotta go. Hope you have a great week. And hey, you too, Robert. Take care. Also, everybody, that's Robert Douglas. He's playing ROM hacks. He plays Half-Life mods. And occasionally, he does play Sonic. So he is be known a bit of a Sonic fanatic with the rings. I can't say it like he does, because he has passion. And he does hate himself enough to try to play Doom on Nightmare with fast monsters. But nonetheless, go check him out. Hit him up. He might be your cup of tea. He might be your cup of Robert. But nonetheless, hit up all of his social. It's all for free. In fact, do that for Vash. He does Doom. Oh, let's say Doomed. I should put it more like that. Doom Shumps. Go check him out. He also does a lot of Quake. Ugh. I would say... what would you call those? Not retro achievements, but just batshit insane challenges. But he does retro achievements too, along with Jaguar RN. Go hit up all these lovely folks. Trust me, they're way more skilled and better than I. Robert, take care and have a good one, man. I do appreciate the conversation tonight. I hope when you lay your head on your pillow, you get a lot of sleep. Because right now, I know I'm not. I can't even fucking hit him. Aw, oh, suck it. The slime hurts. Come on, come on. No, no, no. God damn it, where's that loving feeling, Virtuos? Oh, I was hoping to pull off with a one heart hit. Oh, the question if Minecraft came out from your generation would be you hate it. If Minecraft came out. No, Nat, I hate it because it's a fucking drooling imbecile fucking game. It could come out in the fucking 90s. Maybe if I was a child, I'd be more impressed with it. But looking at it when it came out for the, like, the Xbox 360 time, I played a little bit and put it down because I realized what fucking... it just, it's for fucking morons. I'm sorry. I don't think highly of people who play Minecraft. You know what I usually respond to, Nat, and it's gotten me in trouble with some of my coworkers? Yeah, I like Minecraft. Oh, so how long have you been retarded? Because I don't respect that fucking game. I don't respect the fucking drooling, dribbling masses who can't fucking break themselves away to play anything else of any kind of adverse or challenge. Don't give me the Minecraft survival shit either. I wipe my ass with that. Go play something else. Go play anything fucking else. Minecraft has got to be one of the most boring fucking games to me. And I'm sorry, when I see adults play it online... or stream it, to me, they're just scalping kids for fucking their parents' fucking money, because that's usually what it amounts to. Then later you come to find out they're fucking goddamn pedophiles. I'm sorry, PDF files, or whatever the fucking term is now. I don't get fucking all hot and bothered about it, Nat. I'm sorry. Dragon Quest Builders is the game. That's what it was. Because my brother's daughters liked it. That's how I got introduced to it. And I only like it because of the twist on the first Dragonware. But other than that, I really can't tolerate it. It's mid at best. And that's even with the Dragon Warrior facade. The one dungeon I really wish fire magic worked. Back to not being able to hit. That one down here. Oh, that's low. Aw, god damn it, he saw me. Damn, dude, being bullied because someone likes him. Nat, it's not the other game shit I'm talking about, man. It's the drooling fucking idiot that it makes you. Like, you can like something bad. I love fucking bad horror movies. But I got enough sense to realize when garbage is garbage. You can like Minecraft. I don't fault you for liking Minecraft. It's when you can't pull yourself fucking away from it that worries me. It's like the slang that me and Robert were discussing. I'm in there with a fucking Vietnam vet who's in his 70s right now. And we're sitting there discussing certain shit. and the kid who's 15, who's in a more professional setting, who's been shadowing me, starts using fucking, what is it, jelly, a bunch of other fucking shit that poured out of his mouth that I just stopped listening to. To the point where the guy just said, hey man, I've been around the world a lot and I still can't understand what the fuck you're saying. Can you please have him step out of the room? And I even stepped out of the room and said, hey dude, you're not in trouble. Don't think this is it. He's not angry at you. He's just confused. Just go have a seat right now. Take your fucking 10. You're cool. But when it comes to fucking Minecraft, that's like a breeding ground for dribbling fools, and I don't feel sorry for fucking hating it. Would you bully me? Go ahead and bully me then. I'm sorry, Nat, I'm not participating in your kink shame, your kinks. Alright, let's do this. Doubt it'll work. Or 2-for-1. Oh my god! Son of a bitch! Oh, I earned that game over. I fucking earned it. That was awesome. God damn it, that was a fucking thrill. Let's go get this fixed real fast, because I know I'm going to be needing it soon. I'm on Pondicherry. Oh, finally bumped up to 50. Big trouble, you ain't shitting me on that one. So what else games do you like, Nat? It can't just be the ones you say, so what else are you into? I knew better, yet I went anyways. Don't ask. It's a complicated relationship I share with this. Didn't want to do 25, but it's better than 5. I got great luck today. Filled up. I really do like the bug catching in this one. There we are. Oh, give me arrows. I have a feeling I'm gonna need a lot more for the boss coming up. 1251. Remember the girl who shot and killed her mom? Alright, give me 1 second. Matt, she has shit coming out of her nose. 1251.
On scene to the Smiley home. His body cam video showed Carly's stepfather, Heath, falling immediately to the ground as soon as Deputy Lewis knocked on the door.
Yeah, Rip is right.
Hello?
Man, that is a thick accent. I always wonder what comes to Fox's mind when they arrest a minor and not 17-year-old, but like 10 or 15-year-old. I don't know, Nat. What do you think goes through their minds?
A couple minutes later, emergency crews arrived and Heath is heard telling them it was his stepdaughter who shot him and killed her mom, leaving them shocked the shooting happened at the hands of a 14-year-old girl.
Does she have any kind of, what's her name? But
Carly Gregg.
Carly Gregg?
Yeah.
How old is she?
14. She'll be 15 next month.
Okay. Matt, what do you think he did wrong with the stepmother? I could kind of understand her being antisocial with the haircut that makes her look like Mo Howard. No, she is. You can see it in her face. Well, that's why I'm kind of reserving judgment for what really happened here, because so far we just know of her crime and the police video. I don't know if there was any kind of fucking other thing going on here. You don't know if there is domestic violence. You don't know if there is... It could be everything you could ever imagine going on all at once for all the fuck we know. So I'm always kind of iffy on these videos. She was abused by her biological dad, and that's what I haven't heard about the stepdad. Matt, it only takes one time for her to have a flashback of something and then her go back into that mode. So for all we know, he couldn't have been a bad person at all. He could have just reprimanded her by being grounded. I was actually kind of, I wouldn't say enjoying it, but I was picking up a lot of information from it. Since I'm going to be doing this for a while, Nat, actually, let me check the time here. Fuck, I almost have to go. Let me check something here, because I think it's... where is it here? Yep, 70 arrows for... or 70 for arrows... and 50 bombs. All right, I wasn't too far off because I thought it was going to be 80 arrows. So I'm 10 under that one, and bombs it's 50. Let me cancel out of that one. I think this was Mississippi though. Yeah, I kind of hold it against her from being from there, Nat. So No, it is what it is. Nat, you want me to put on some music the last 5 minutes? Or do you want to just listen to me enter and exit a dungeon for a few times? Because I'm probably going to do it till I run out of money here. What's a good song from Murder Time? Entering dungeon. Let's do this one instead. I'll give you a break from it. My brother sent me this one a few months back. This one's called Spooky Autumn Music, The Lost Woodland by Brandon Fletcher's Music. Go check him out. I'll drop the link. But if you find folks want to bandy on over and get some, give my guess. I'm actually starting to really like the music he's been sending me lately. Spoopy? Nat, I'll ban you for that. I hate when people say spoopy. It makes me want to slap the fucking shit out of them. Don't talk to me like a fucking toddler, please. That's it. You're banned. You're cut the fuck off. No more for you. No more mod ship either. You can't handle it. You know what? You're in the friend zone now, Nat. You're a VIP. How do you feel about that? Ah, I see you're doubling down. Well, I guess I have to take action. I can't find it. I'll do it later. Fuck it. You'll be punished later. Consider yourself only by my good graces. Can you adopt me, please? I don't think you want that, Nat. I just had to move into another apartment. It's kind of weird. I think my neighbors are cooking cabbage a lot. I don't know. That's not too bad of a song. I'll try another one. Here's another one he sent me. Where is it? Where are you? I'm always afraid to add these to Murder Times because they don't feel like they fit. They're kind of too good, if you know what I mean. I don't know if you guys have ever experienced that. Where is it here? But I do like the name of some of these. They sound like they're right out of Fable. Oh, it's right here, Nat. Go down, and it's official. For me, it's the second row. It's the Zelda map. By the way, I use that one because it looks like a flyer you're handing somebody to make it official.
It's official. You suck.
There you go.
It's official. Oh, you God. Suck.
You're not going to abuse that, are you, Nat? Thank you. Ah, God, I love my mods. They're so uplifting. You know, they just chase away the rain. This one here is from... I'll put the link for this one, too. This is Spooky Autumn Music, Candlelit Forest, Fantasy, and World Music by Fletchers. I'll leave it at that. Adopt his mod. Nat, if I could, I would. Throw in a few. And that's all I can do. Ah, that was fucking good. I really had a fun time tonight. I'd like to thank everybody who did show up. I really do fucking appreciate you guys. I really do. I'd like to thank everybody for the fucking conversation we had. That was metal as fuck. Nat, I didn't mean a fucking thing I said. Don't worry. That goes for everybody else. Where is it here? What raiding out music to go with? Let's go with Wizardry again. I mean on the pandas, Nat. They're cute little furry little bastards. I do like them. But I do kind of find it funny when people only discover red pandas existed after watching a Gretzko. I have never seen a Gretzko. It doesn't interest me. But it's kind of like when people adopted huskies after watching two episodes of Game of Thrones. That's the feeling I get with red pandas. Like, people only care about them as long as they're in their little zeitgeist of them. And then after that, the red pandas are declared extinct tomorrow, no one give a shit. I know, Nat, it just doesn't interest me. There's a girl I work with, Nat, who likes a cartoon called Hey Hey Puffy Ami Yumi or something like that. And that's her plead to my case. Here you go, Nat. Let me help you with that.
It's official. You suck.
God, I love the old Shao Kahn voice a lot better than the new ones. Well, I wouldn't say the newest one. Like, from about 9 up to technically 1, it's really good. But the OG one is still the fucking best. If anybody's still here and has anybody you guys like me to raid, go ahead and send it on in. I think I can see send someone to found someone to send you to. He's playing Risen today. Now, if you guys don't know, that's open world, but not in the vein you would think it is. And I really do love Piranha Bytes games or Deep Silver. They're not they don't have the lore like Skyrim, or I keep saying Skyrim, Elder Scrolls, but man, their open world is pretty fucking good. How do you feel about 2D animations on the mainstream anime? Not bad, Nat. Like, it really just does depend on what they animate. Oh, I already know they would, Nat. They saw money signs. If they can keep Jack Black out of it. The only way Jack Black is going to star in FNAF, if I hope, like, fuck, is he's getting stabbed to death and dismembered by every member. And I mean of the crew. I want the cameraman to come on stream, put Jack Black into Springtrap, or I think that's what you called him, and knife him to fucking death. Because I know he can't play the fucking hero or anything of that crowd. But then again, I don't have to worry about that. I think the comment section will do that for me. I'm gonna send you guys over to Iceman. He's playing Risen. You can get it on GOG and Steam, where I own it, where if you're old school Xbox, it's kind of like Two Worlds, if you guys know what I'm talking about. It's a little bit of open world with that chef's kiss of jank. God, do I love it. And it is a hard, brutal, unforgiving game, which means pretty fucking cool, too. Respect Iceman, or I should say Iceman1779, good year. And his channel rules. And everybody else who is here, you guys can go back and check. Jaguar RN, Zash, and Robert Douglas, along with Illegitimate Son of God, respect them and drop a like, follow, and sub. Help everybody out. It'll make you feel good in your bones. That kiss scared me. I'm sorry, Nat. I really do like Risen. I really do like how that game was. I really would like to have seen a more kind of build onto it, but it kind of perished after 3. You do have Elix, which I do like 1 and 2 of, but it is what it is. Alright, I'm gonna get out of here, guys. Stop making ASMR noises. You guys later. Take care.